So you can immediately see here that for variant analysis, let's talk about this particular application, these alignments are really important. After mapping, you will get something that looks like this. So these are your reads, and this is the genome sequence, the reference genome. And you see that by doing the mapping, you can already see where possible variants are located. So the whole variant calling is based on the alignment, the mapping of the reads to the reference genome sequence. So this alignment will allow you to detect possible mutations in your reads. So you see that for variant analysis, the mapping is crucial. The whole analysis will be based on the results of the mapping. And this is why for variant analysis, people take a lot of time to do the mapping as good as possible, because it's so crucial there. So you see, what are the variants here? Well, the variants are, of course, the differences, bases that are different in your reads compared to the genome sequence. Now, I have explained that sequencing, next-gen sequencing, is not error-free. It generates a lot of sequencing errors, much more than traditional Sanger sequencing. So that means that you need to have a way to make a distinction between variants and between sequencing errors.